Authentication apps use time-based passcodes for account security, but the accounts can be lost or deleted. We'll show you how to instantly restore all your authentication app accounts on another device. Hello everyone, this is Rick with CyberMedics. Today we are talking about authentication apps for added account security. Accounts tied to authentication apps are vulnerable to being wiped out if you delete the app or you lose your device. We'll show you how to eliminate this vulnerability through Microsoft Cloud Backup. The Cloud Backup doesn't function normally, which will be explained at the end. Before we dive into the authentication app, we'll do a brief explanation of second factor authentication. 2FA is something you know, like a PIN or a password, plus something you have, an authentication app or a hardware security key, or something you are, a retina scan, a fingerprint scan, or a facial scan. If you'd like additional details on second factor authentication, there's a link to a video we did above. Authenticator apps are used as part of 2FA. In addition to your password, you enter usually a six-digit PIN. Displayed here is the authentication app from Microsoft on the iPhone and also on the Android phone. The problem is, once these accounts are added, if you delete the application or lose the device, all of these authentication accounts will be gone. So we're going to walk you through a protection procedure and show you how this works with the Microsoft Authentication app. In here on the Microsoft Authenticator under Settings, there's something called the Cloud Backup. Now, if that's turned on, then you will have a record copy backed up to the cloud of all your accounts. You also have a cloud backup on the iPhone, and you can see it's the iCloud backup. Now, these two are not cross-platform compatible. So the backup on the Android and the backup on the iCloud are completely separate because Apple forces Microsoft to back this up to the iCloud. Over here, they're using their Microsoft Cloud Backup services. So next, let's go through the cloud backup procedure. This is not as straightforward as you might think. The only way to get changes that you make in the application here, if you added an account or deleted an account, is to go in to the cloud backup, turn it off. Once you turn it back on, you'll be able to recover your account. So don't worry about that. Say okay. Now it's deleted the backup. So there is no backup associated with this account anymore. And then we turned on the backup. Whatever changes we have made at that point, they will be backed up. And it will tell you the particular Microsoft account that you're backing it up to. If you have more than one Microsoft account on the application, it will give you the choice to change accounts if you so choose. I think it's worth going through this cloud backup procedure just to show you how this works. So in this Tutanota, what we're going to do is we're going to delete this account. I'm going to remove the account. Let me say, are you sure you want to remove the account? Yes, we're going to say remove the account. Now, what we're going to do on the Android phone is we're going to go in, we're going to uninstall the app, and we're going to confirm and say OK. We'll go back into the Play Store and install the app. Open it back up. And the first thing you'll be presented with is a screen, and down here at the bottom, it'll say Restore from Backup. And you'll sign in with the account that you have linked to the backup. So we can come over here and select 72. Now it's recovering from backup. There you go. And you can see all the accounts are back. So if you really want the changes to take effect, what you have to do is, in this case, we would come in here and we would delete this account and say remove the account. And then what you have to do is you have to come in here under the settings and you have to turn this backup off. Your backup is deleted. This account is gone. So now if we turn the backup back on again, it will register that because now it's going to back up the instance. And you say okay. And so whatever accounts are here or not here, at that point when you turn the backup on is the only point where it's actually doing the backup. And I'll demonstrate that by coming back into here again. So we're uninstalling the app so that we can show you how it instantiated the backup. Install the app again. Okay, we're selecting restore from backup again, asking us to sign in. 56 over here. There we go. Covering from the backup. And this time the account should be deleted because we turned it off and turned it back on. And there you go. You can see the Tutanota account was deleted. So to recap that procedure, we deleted the account. We came into settings. We turned this off. This time we got our scary statement and we say, okay, sure, we turned it off. Okay. And the account here was deleted. And then we went back into settings and we turned the cloud backup back on. I just keep going over that because for me, it's counterintuitive. Normally on a backup system, you make changes, you get backed up. In this case, you turn off the backup, turn the backup back on, and the changes are saved. And I believe Microsoft does that because they want you to explicitly save the changes. But for an end user that's adding accounts, you may falsely assume backed up, and they're not. Until you turn it off and turn it back on, the backup does not occur. This concludes our video demonstration of how to protect your 2FA accounts with Microsoft Authenticator. Would you please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel? This supports our efforts in helping others with technology. Post any questions or comments below and have a great and wonderful automation day.